Sorry ya. Okay. And mungkin hari ini I want to announce my retirement for the 19 years in VM. And I think this decision I very tough to do the this decision after I go to Esther last my checked out in Taiwan. And I get back, I get back to my family. I think I go to VM, so I take the 1 month rest. I just discuss with my family and do the this decision. And because I go to April and last I go to Taiwan. And before I go, my trainer give me the question for my the doctor. Right, and muscles are training tough, how to recover and everything. And my doctor see that this little drug, I think the training for the medicine, I think it's a very high intensity. Yeah. And I just talked to my wife, I think my wife is here. Right. And after I talked to my wife, and I just discussed this doctor. He just called me to rest. And I think I think kasih saya memang berat lah untuk want to continue for the high intensity sport. And saya akan balik minta BM cuti 1 bulan. And just discuss to my family after I can do for the cooking Noza and Wabisa tadi. And sebelum raya. And kita buat an edition after raya, kita akan announce untuk saya retirement. And memang saya buat edition memang berat untuk saya. Because I really love this sport. And this is more important untuk saya pertama memang sekarang untuk health lah. It's more important untuk saya. And saya akan jumpa Wabisa Kami and Tepsi Noza around 1 hour discuss for the Wabisa Kami the house. And before raya, and saya akan do a decision after take 1 month rest. And now I just bought that announcement, I retire. And I think more important, I want to thank you and today all the media. And 19 years and all of this media and my friends via Malaysia and all the way support saya. I think bukan senang saya bawa selalu pakai baju gemilang Malaysia and all the way go to whole world and play in all the tournaments. I think I will proud myself also. I can give the best result to my country. And I think it's more important, a lot of people, maya orang, saya mau terima kasih juga. And I think first, I want to cakap and thank you KBS, MSN, ISN. And I think more important is BM. I think I think longer than 19 years in the BM. I think I'm special, I want to thank all my coaches. First, my coach is helping me out with the Dr. Dispoon. I think I don't know if here. I think there are a few coaches. I think it's here. And Coach Anwar, I think it's here. Coach Shubok, I think it's Coach Luke here, I think. I can see his heart. And Coach Luke is Nico Saya around more in 13 years. In the ISF Israel, Abang Pandey, my trainer, Rose Lee, Sandra, and my master, the pastor, around 15 years, follow me.
Steady.
And more important, I want to thank my family, my wife. It's more important. And last, I want to thank you, Malaysian. No Malaysian will be joined at the Nigerian international team. And all the way fighting for my country. Thank you.
Bagus sekali. Senang memanggil untuk kita semua memberikan tepukan yang paling gemuruh sekali kepada hero negara Dato' Lee Chong Wei. I grew up watching Dato' fly the Malaysian flag proudly. Not in stadiums, by watching through the television. Dan saya agak yakin banyak generasi, banyak rakyat Malaysia juga melalui pengalaman yang sama. Dan Dato' Lee Chong Wei is a hero to all Malaysians. From all backgrounds, all ethnicities, all religions. Malaysia yang dibilang bangsa dan agama, semua akan bersama, bersatu hati untuk memberikan sokongan yang padu apabila kita melihat Dato' Lee Chong Wei mewakili Malaysia di pentas antarabangsa. Untuk kita mencari lagi seorang figura ataupun idola seperti Dato' Lee Chong Wei memang sukar. Someone like him comes once in a lifetime. And Malaysians, including myself, are privileged to have someone like him. As I mentioned to Dato' Lee Chong Wei before, to Dato' Noza, when we were at my house about a few weeks before Raya, is that while the decision of retirement was made, walaupun beliau pilih untuk bersara, tetapi roh perjuangan Dato' Lee Chong Wei tidak akan terbenam ataupun terpendam. While he retires, the fighting spirit of Dato' Lee Chong Wei will burn in the hearts and minds of all athletes in Malaysia, not just in badminton, but all athletes. I mean, the fact that even after knowing that he had to go through a few medical processes, it's quite tough. Pada masa tersebut, dia masih mengambil keputusan untuk terus bermain, terus berlatih. He didn't stop, which shows that he's a true fighter like no other out there. From the ministry side, no matter what path he chooses to take after this, as I mentioned to him, we will give our full support to Dato' Lee. He is the hero to all Malaysians, and at the same time, while he may have retired, but after talking to Dato' Lee and also to Dato' Sri Norza, we have decided collectively to nominate Dato' Lee Chong Wei as the next chief de mission for the Tokyo Olympics. Reason being is simple, we cannot think of anyone better to fly the Malaysian flag high, to also give inspiration to our young athletes. As I mentioned that Dato' Lee Chong Wei's fighting spirit will be in the hearts and minds of all the athletes who bring the Malaysian flag, who wear the Jalur Gemilang, and I believe that his contribution to Malaysia will always be there in our hearts and minds. So Dato' Lee, thank you very much. You are my hero. You are Malaysia's hero. It's an absolute privilege to be given the opportunity to serve you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yang berhormat Menteri Belia Nasukan Tuan Syed Saddiq, Yang berhormat YB Stephen Sim, Timbalan Menteri, Dato' Wira Lee Chong Wei, Fellow Council of PAM, members of the media, and all those present today. I am amongst you today with a very mixed emotions. Very sad as a badminton lover, as I will no longer witness a legend whose style, grace, and daily like poetry in motion on the badminton court inspired many to watch and play the game. Very sad as a Malaysian, as I will no longer have a legend who is always ever dependable and one who not only himself wears, but also inspire others to wear the Jalur Gemilang with such pride and honor. Sad as the President of Badminton Association of Malaysia, as we accept the decision made today that our legend has decided to call it a day on court. But I also feel happy and privileged. Happy that Dato' Wiradi is able to call it quits on his own terms. Privileged to have served and be involved in badminton during the time of this legend, a national hero whose many achievements, particularly at the Olympics, have united this nation like no other one can. Be it the Olympics, or the All England, or the World Championship, Malaysians, regardless of colour, race, religion, politics and differences, watch, hope and pray for the boy from Penang to bring us home fame and glory at the international level. And indeed, almost always, he never failed us. Even in the times of when success eluded him, he showed to us the true spirit of a Malaysian. He fought till the end, giving his blood, sweat and tears to the nation. I am also privileged to have known this legend, not just as a player, but as a person, to see him grow in BAM into the gentleman that he is today. Despite all his successes and riches, he remains ever so humble, respectful, and above all, still the same hunger for success as the day he first started. His hunger is not just for his own, but for Malaysian badminton. On this note, I'm hopeful and sure that Dato' Wiradi will remain amongst us to chart the future and to find his replacement. Indeed, the world will miss the King of Super Series, and Malaysian will miss our national sporting hero and icon. In a generation of truly great players, you are the best. On behalf of BAM Council, coaches, players and staff, thank you for all your contribution and memories. You know, these mixed feelings, I don't know, there's no real words to describe my feelings towards Chong Lin. But, you know, there's a song by Priyam Lee, Di Mana Kan Ku Cari Ganti. And I don't think, you know, for many years to come, we will not be able to have a great player like Chong Lin. Thank you, Chong Lin.
Doctor just advised me, boleh kurangkan, paling kurangkan my pressure. And I think you see my trainer for the team, even the Christian, I think not suitable. I go on to high level intensity training and competition. And after I treatment in last year, I think he's followed me and all the way in my meals. And I think he told me, I think a lot of pressure in your shoulder. And he just me call, I think you need the rest. He don't call me retired, and I just call me. You need the rest, and then you think yourself. And I know what you mean. And I just in Taiwan, I just told my wife and my family. And I just beg landing, I just call my coach, because I need the rest and take the 1 month rest. I think I want to do this decision is very tough. Because after I get the treatment back, I just back in the court for the 6 months. I want to try again. And if I don't want to be my spirit, want to play, I think after my treatment, I just call, retire. And I want to try again. And after my trainer, just give me a lot of 8 questions and call my doctor, right? Back for my trainer. And he just encouraged me, just tell me I need to leave the rest. And I just do this very tough decision and my family. I think this is time I must step down to my career, 19 years in the national team. And I think it's more important now is my health. I always every year go to Japan. I think this Olympic in 2 years, 2 years Japan, I think it must do the best in this Asian Olympic years. I think this is my dream also want to go. And because last year I got the this treatment, and I just back in this 6 month try. Also my dream want to come to the fifth time for the Olympic. And just now I say I very tough and do this decision. And also first, also want to thank you for the YD Sai and Dr. Tim Musa give me the chip to be sure bring the Malaysia full Olympic team go to the Tokyo Olympic, still go, there's no play. I just encourage hope so we athletes can get the first gold medal to Malaysia. And this is also my dream. And I cannot get, I think I can hope Malaysia, the athlete go get the first gold group for my country. I think I need first, I need the rest first. And just recover, fully recover in my body. And after I think, see how I discuss to what this has done. And also the Badminton Association President. 100% is BAM, Malaysia need my help. 100% just back in the sports. Yeah, I think saya rasa dia boleh. And just more important, what he want, the player is more important. Saya selalu cakap, and if you have the whole world in the best coach coming in Malaysia, is personally dia tak mau, dia tak boleh juga. It's more important, apa you mau, personal players, what you want. This is more important. With that, I cannot say regret because this is more important now is my health. And just now I told many times I want to do this decision is very tough because I take around 1 month and I discuss to my family. And I do a decision also first I told Dr. Srinoza and YB Sasade. I just call and I want to meet up to YB Sasade and Dr. Srinoza. I think this decision is for me because my plan is next year after Olympics. And because I do decision because my health and I just do decision before Olympics, I do a decision and retire. Yeah. I think saya rasa bukan senang maupun ICDM sebelum Dato' Sri and YB Sasadi buat any decision. Saya ada cakap juga, I think buat untuk atlet, I think saya boleh lah. And selalu saya akan bawa team Thomas Cup and team Sulman Cup. Saya buat team captain, I think saya akan buat yang terbest. And saya sekarang Dato' Sri juga, I must learn for the this is mau bawa ini team Olympic apa yang pergi next year. Saya akan cubalah buat yang terbaik untuk atlet kita, untuk negara. I think saya akan buat apa yang saya boleh, saya mampu, saya akan try my best and help this Olympic team go to Tokyo 2020. Yeah. First is betul-betul sebab cakap I don't take the rest because I hutang sama wife after my married 2012 and then saya perlu handphone lagi ya. And saya utang dia sudah lama, I think that 7 years. And because everybody know, I expect in a tournament 1 week I must change, and I just go to other tournament back in 1 week, because badminton you cannot totally stop in 1 week, other 2 weeks you must continue to training, because badminton the schedule is very tight. And I just continue, I just no time being my wife go to honeymoon, I just go to holiday. And this is the time for me, I think, take a rest and just take my wife go to holiday and a honeymoon. I think I just plan and this few weeks, and I get the time to spend to my wife. And now I have the 2 kids also. And now you still have school. After the school holiday, I must spend some time to my kids. And before I do this press conference, my son always in home court, Eddie. And he always see badminton in Sulaiman Cup. And I see the Malaysia team. Why Popo Tia lose and everything, he told Eddie. Why did you not play? I also don't know how to explain to my son. And this morning I wake up and my wife just sent one photo for me. My son write for me, "Daddy, you the best." And I just see the picture, I just cry. And I think I very tough. I do a decision just now, and I hope so. And I take the rest and I spend some time with my family and my mom, my all my family, and I might bring my wife go to honeymoon first. I think my career same in roller coaster, going down, going up, going down, going up. And I think I want to first also thank you, Dato' Sri Norza. I think he knows so many years in badminton association president. I still remember, and one time I lost in All England, first round, he know you arrived. And he arrived, I lost already. And he just go into my room, he called me, "It's okay, don't wait." And I just try my best, and always top player can lose in first round, because always in the seeding higher, and anybody want to beat you, and I'm more patient in my side, right? And I just lose in first round. I still remember after I doubt, and I just go, "Don't wait, it's okay, keep it up." And after he said, "When you back?" I say, "I take the rest here few days." After Dato' Sri say, "Okay, I just follow you back to Malaysia." I still remember after I arrived in Malaysia, you know, a lot of press meeting in the airport. I also how. I want to say, people are losing first round. And Dato' Sri say, "Okay, you don't need to go. I go first, you go in front." Just, and he's just helping me how to talk to press. I still remember. I think this is always in my mind. Just cycle me and just keep it up. A lot of people support you. Also, the president go to All England, see you play. When you lose first round, you never arrive. Never see your match, you lose already. And it's just follow you going back to Malaysia, and first you go in front, talk to press. And after I just think myself, it's okay, this is tournament, lose first round and have the next tournament. I think still this is I very think a lot of things. And second is my doping case. I spent 8 months, also that was three, just always fight with me. And, go to hearing, everything. I still remember my tough, very tough time. And just now I say, my life and my career came in a roller coaster, going down, going up, going down, going up. I think I still this, this is my memory and tough time. I hope you can qualify for the 5th Olympic also, and I'm just a dream. And for me, it's my enemy also. And he just tried his best, and I think he's very very tough, because China has a Chen Long and a Su Yiqi, and because only country can go 2 players go to Olympic. I wish him all the best. I can be the 5th time the Olympics.
Seperti yang saya bincangkan sebelum ni dengan Datuk Lee, ada perancangan tersendiri bagi Datuk Lee pun ada, tetapi seperti Datuk katakan lebih baik kita berikan masa dahulu. Beliau, this is his moment and his time. And let's respect that. Bila tiba masanya, kami akan maklumkan bersama. Yes, sir.
I think the Malaysia Open. The Malaysia Open Lintan Lingming, the Rubber Game 2013 in Sarawak. I still remember. I think he says, want to get 1 point, want to get the head point. I think I just fight back, I win the this Malaysia Open in Sarawak.
New challenge. Now I need the rest. And my new challenge, my wife, I think I must bring it to holiday first. I promise. And no challenges. I just my blood all also badminton the sport. I told YB Sade, also try YB Stevenson, and also Dr. Singh Nauta. As a 100% I back in the sport. I just help the sport. Not in badminton, I think whole sport. I just try my very best how I can do. I do my best to my country because I'm from Malaysia. I'm gonna try my best and helping to BAM. Just maybe now I still retire, still I can go to court. Just worry, just train and youngster for the preparation for the other tournament. And maybe Zijia and a few youngster must qualify to Olympic. And also we can qualify more the next year Olympic. Yeah, this is also all my good friend. And in outside group friend, in the court also enemy. And also in my Yonex family. And same sponsor and be the always do in the laser vision in the whole world. And this year I think we have the laser vision in the US and in Canada with Marco also. And just support this sport. And I think every year we have a lot this laser vision. And also we bring a lot of country and it's a big sport. And I think more important is more people play in the badminton in the whole world. I think now it's sport badminton, I think it's the top five in the world. Yeah, I think I want to thank you, Yonex also. I think the longer sponsor me in my career, 15 years in the Yonex sponsor. Second is under plus 12 years in my career, and third, Samsung, 10 years in my personal sponsorship. And these three, I think, is a longer sponsor. And I think Yonex the best in the badminton equipment, I think whole world also know. And he always just have the new product and new technology, always just call me, either he's come to Malaysia, either we go to Japan, just testing the new technology, what you want, and then he's sit down and discuss with all the players. And I think I never regret and this sponsorship and this sponsor. I think before I retire, I just discuss with all my sponsor, and he also sent me the letter. It's more important now is my health, and he very appreciate, and also so long time relationship in all my sponsor. And also thank you and BM also. I relationship in 19 years. Never say no good things. And I think I all the way in a very good relationship, and all the association and my sponsor, and also MSN, ISN. I think I want to talk in the first. Only one I cannot successful. I must a lot. The people must help me, and I say just now, KBF, MSN, ISN, Badminton Association, and my physio, just now I mentioned, follow me, I think 15, 13 years, I think it's not easy, because I always need people help, and thank you so much, and all are helping me, so 19 years, I think it's not easy. Regret is 100%. I regret I get gold medal and also Olympic. Now is YB and Dato Sri Nauta just give me the chance to bring the Olympic 2020. This also my dream. I cannot get. I also Malaysia actually can get the one gold for the Malaysia. This also my dream. I can do the best achievement for the Olympic for next year.
So I have 36 now, 19 years, I think more than half of my life, right? I think I missed all the media.
I think this is
my last press conference and applaud the people. Just now, YB Sasadis just go in, right? He says, macam dia pernah fight PM Raya masa itu Maya reporter. I think I missed all the reporter. And thank you. And for my career, 19 years, all the way, takkan saya menang ke saya kalah. I think this is the more important, this media all the way support saya. I miss you all, serious, I miss you all. And also miss my badminton academy. Because 19 years I in the BAM, tak kisah untuk cuci tandasnya kakak ke, sapu lantai itu kakak, itu semua kawan-kawan banyak. Itu tolong saya juga, kadang saya kat hostel, tolong saya cuci. This is I think one thanks all the BAM, all the Riot Malaysian. I think more important, Riot Malaysian, all the way support my career. Tak kisah saya kalah, they keep it up, my spirit. And all the reporter, Dr. Pinoza, Masa Zemba Tafem, and keep it my spirit, and my family, and my sponsor, I think whole BAM staff and council member. And I selalu saya cakap, jangan tengok kita BAM staff duduk kat office. I think must thank you a lot because tadi dia itu semua orang saya tak boleh keluar competition. This is all his arrangement. Saya selalu keluar dari tournament, etiquette, hotel, everything, and all the team manager, coaches. And seriously, I want to special thanks Malaysian and all the my coaches. I think sometimes I playing, saya nak coach lebih pressure sama saya. Tapi itu, I think coach Hendrawan mana. Commonwealth game, I still remember Commonwealth game and Seven. 2017 and Hendrawan and Kusubo, my last matches in place Sri Kan final. I think 2-0. Itu malam tak tidur. Ya tak tidur and I think my coach sometimes sakit juga. I think the more pressure to me and also the Olympic game. I still remember Dato' Sri Noza and my two coach 2016. I think the 3 o'clock dia bagi makan breakfast pagi. Tapi saya tak tahu lah, tapi orang nampak dia pukul 3 pagi dia pergi kantin makan breakfast. I think I also cannot sleep same in the Olympic game. I think my coaches also my appreciation because dia duduk belakang, saya tahu juga. And thank you so many years and all the my coaches and the reporter Riot Malaysia. Today is my retirement day and also I wish all the media and all the Riot Malaysia get help and everyday happiness and I see you soon. Thank you.